Dear friends in Christ, we have come together in the presence of God, our Heavenly Father, to give him thanks and praise for the gift of his Son, our meek and righteous King, who by his death became our Savior from sin and eternal death. By his Holy Spirit, may he enlighten, govern, and direct us, that we may ever remain faithful to this righteous King and Savior, and not be offended by his humble form and despised word, but firmly believing in him, obtain eternal salvation and the fullness of joy in heaven. To this end, may God the Father grant us his grace through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Daughter of Zion, surely your salvation is coming. Rejoice, daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord will cause his glorious voice to be heard, and you shall have gladness of hearts. Give ear, O shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph like a flock. Stir up your strength and come and save us. Unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things.
Thank you.
St. Paul writes by inspiration to the Romans in chapter 5. Therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand, and rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. And not only that, but we also glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance, and perseverance character, and character hope. Now hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out in our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. For when we were still without strength, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. St. Paul writes to the Galatians, "Now I say that the heir, as long as he is a child, does not differ at all from a slave, though he is master of all, but is under guardians and stewards until the time appointed by the father. Even so we, when we were children, were in bondage under the elements of the world. But when the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has sent forth the Spirit of his Son into your hearts, crying out, 'Abba, Father.' Therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ."
I stand beside my
St. Paul writes to the Philippians, "Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant, and coming in the likeness of men, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. Therefore, God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven and those on earth and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father."
Thank you.
the evangelist St. Luke writes, "And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you that of your mercy and compassion, you caused your Son to become incarnate, and through him redeemed us from sin and everlasting death. We beseech you, enlighten our hearts by your Holy Spirit, that we may ever be thankful for such grace and comfort ourselves thereby in all tribulation and temptation, and at last obtain eternal salvation through the same your beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one true God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen.
Amen.